Map of the Soul 7 is out February 21st here to perform Black Swan for the first time on television. Please welcome BTS.
The album is called Love Yourself Her. Here are the song Mic Drop Remix, BTS.
They are a groundbreaking global phenomenon who are here in Grand Central Terminal tonight for a historic performance, performing on from their new album, Map of the Soul 7. Give it up for BTS!
Korean pop music, commonly referred to as K-pop, is a region-specific genre of music that in recent years has evolved to a worldly phenomena. K-pop was not always such a superpower in the music industry. 10 years ago, most North Americans would not be able to name one K-pop band. Now, bands like BTS are selling out stadiums in the US to over 50,000 fans. K-pop is widely defined through use of bright colors on sets and costumes, and incredibly complex choreographed dances. It is no surprise the level of time and effort required to constantly produce these aspects would result in such a widely appreciated art form. Especially looking at what pop has been popular in American history, for example, Michael Jackson, who almost perfectly matches the K-pop aesthetic. The only foreseeable limit to the rise of K-pop in the West would have been that of the language barrier, which has since been proven to have no real effect on the limits of K-pop's popularity. Most fans at an American BTS concert do not speak Korean, they just enjoy the music and performance. Surprisingly, the K-pop community, specifically the fans of K-pop, are massively involved in political activism, especially related to the Black Lives Matter movement. Through social media platforms such as Twitter, K-pop fans directly fight racial discrimination and spread awareness of the Black Lives Matter movement. The Black Lives Matter movement began in 2013 following the murder of Trayvon Martin. The movement was started by three women, Alicia Garza, Patrice Cullors, and Opal Tometi, to combat the police killings of black people. The movement quickly grew following the far too many police killings of black people in the years 2014 and 15. In 2016, over 100 protests took place all across America and black athletes began to protest at sports games. This started with Colin Kaepernick, who knelt during the anthem at a football game. In 2018, the hashtag Black Lives Matter had been used roughly 30 million times. In 2020, the tragedy of George Floyd sparked a number of protests all around the world. In the past couple years, K-pop fans have engaged in a number of activities that directly support the Black Lives Matter movement. K-pop fans will hijack racist tweets such as White Lives Matter and Blue Lives Matter, filling them with pictures and videos of their favorite K-pop stars to disrupt the spread of hate and racial discrimination. Last year, fans of K-pop banded together on Twitter and organized a Trump protest together while still remaining spread out all over the country and likely not meeting most of each other. They did this by buying all the tickets to a Trump rally. Trump's administration believed they had sold out the stadium and would be met by thousands of supporters. But when Trump showed up to give his talk, he was faced with many empty seats. During the riots following the George Floyd tragedy, fans of K-pop yet again utilized social media to directly confront the police engaging in brutality all around the United States. They took to specialized police apps that were designed to alert police of raids and riots, but again filled the apps with pictures and videos of their favorite K-pop stars. This was done to protect the individuals trying to protest. On the contrary to all the productive activism the fans of K-pop engage in, what is most frequently done by the community is the spread of love and support to their black peers and anyone who is part of a marginalized group. Fans of K-pop come from all over the world and are often considered social outcasts in terms of Western pop culture. K-pop makes for a safe space and a large network of supportive people with the same or at least similar circumstances to one another. This falls into Lee Rao's ideology regarding social movements. Lee Rao believed in new media, in this case referring to social media and the internet, and its continuously increasing ability to network information quickly through communities. The fan base of K-pop became large due to consuming popular media, but now use social media to build a community with a strong voice that confronts political powers and others that do not support their progressive views. They only report to each other and thus have complete creative control on how and when to protest. They are a very strong and effective group of political activists, and through supporting the right causes will help shape the world to a much better place.